then you go home and take your test.
Welcome back in, everybody.
These people.
Golf Talk Radio with Mike and Billy.
Oh, yeah. And spending all that
in
money.
In the exactly. park.
Nice, buddy.
The 4th of July.
We're just having flashbacks in case you guys join us. We started with Nikki going and doing the NCGA training for course raider and tournament official, and that rolled into rules tests, and then we just morphed into the PGA club professional PGM training management program.
Unbelievable.
It's crazy.
Billy and I were talking at the break. I was having a flashback when level one, because I did zero club repair when I was at Avila Beach before I got into the PGA program. And so Billy helped me because he is a Copeland's. And
I had
this shows how far back this is.
Repair experience about it.
So we do the whole re-gripping thing and whipping and all this stuff. And I had an Instamatic camera.
Oh, yeah.
And I went to get the film developed, and the film got screwed up. So then I had to redo everything, and I had to take up Billy's time. And thank God he took me in as a mentor.
We're buddies, man.
Okay, this is what we're gonna do. And I can just remember the smell, and I remember wearing a Cutter and Buck shirt and khaki pants, and getting the solvent like everywhere. And so we were talking about that at the break, and then Billy. You're saying that you actually had to reshape a head or something?
I was a PGA member twice, believe it or not, way back. This is talking middle 80s or early 80s when I started doing it. It was a whole different thing. It didn't have, you did it a couple times a year, 3 days a year. You had to go to a club repair place, and your head pro wrote you off. You know, you worked for him for a year, yeah. And you got your blue bag, and you went to some courses, and you took some tests. It was
the blue bag,
but you had to go to a club repair center. Mine was in San Diego, and we had to reshaft and regrip, but we also had to refinish a club. So they gave you this wood club. Mine was a laminated wood club, and it had it was cut off at about 6 inches of shaft coming out, but you had to unwhip it. You had to unscrew the sole plates and then and take out the insert. Without damaging it, strip it all down. So you put the stripper chemical on it, so you're burning, everything's burning.
Oh,
and then you could brush it off, sand it, and then you've got to get it really nice and refinish it, and then re-varnish it, put it back together, and get the weight the same. Brutal, man. It was ugly. I can't believe they passed me because it didn't look. It wasn't the best looking club. Insert's a little crooked, but because you try to keep all the pieces. But if you oversand and it takes the weight, now you got to somehow fill the wood. So you have to be really careful on the sander. So if you're not painting, a brown's burn spot. So it was not. I was not the most the best club. It's the only club I've ever refinished and done.
But you didn't realize you were going into woodworking.
I had no idea. I had wood shop in eighth grade. It was nothing. It was so hard. But it had to be perfect, and then if you had a few grams or whatever weight, you had a leeway there, and I barely made it. I think I put some lead tape on the bottom.
Did you?
I think inside the insert, just to weigh it up. I took the insert off with lead tape.
That's you right there. I could see you, and I could see you in class, just like.
Some people pour the lead down the hosel a little bit, right, before they put the steel. The shafts were in there, but they didn't just have a head. We had the shaft. Yeah.
There's Billy.
Oh, and I had stuff in my eyes and epoxy. My ears, my eyes are burning.
Bill, looks good. What? What, Bill? Okay, so what we want you to do is sand down this club. All right? You're going to take this head, this laminated head. You're going to strip it. All right? You're going to reshape it. All right?
No, you can't reshape. You had to leave the shape.
Oh, Bill, you miscut it, Bill. What are you doing?
I could have created some more aerodynamic club.
You put a couple extra coats of varnish on.
Well, because you weigh it while you're doing it, right? You're putting the pieces back, and I knew I took way too much sand. I looked at everybody else's powder near theirs. I had piles, man. I'm like, this isn't good, man. So I did. I added weight where I could, put it back together. You could never hit that club. They checked me off.
Did you have a little thing of like crazy glue right next to you?
Is that epoxy? That's still in my eyes.
Can't get the weight in. Can't get the weight.
I put lead tape inside the face, the insert, and re-screwed the insert.
That's so awesome.
So I had a strip of lead tape to weight the club a little more. Get it back up.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, PGA, for so much stuff.
Yes, thank you, PGA. We love you.
Trip down memory lane.
Keep it on course, people.
Visit the Golf Talk Radio website, golftalkradio.com, to listen to free podcasts and to download the Golf Talk Radio phone app. Follow GTR on Facebook or Twitter. Join us again next week for more local, national, and world golf events, as well as golf trivia and special guests on the Golf Talk Radio Network.